Hello everyone, Xenosim here, and welcome back. Welcome to a new Let's Play of Blaster Master 03. Jason Frontnick, a young luminary in the field of robotics, battled. Mutant forces beneath Earth's surface aboard the old terrain. Battle tank, Sophia the Third, save the planet from certain destruction. Alongside support droid Eve and the mysterious life form, Fred. However, when the dust had settled, mutant cells had begun to corrupt Eve. In order to save her, Jason developed the new Gaia Sophia, space travel. He believed there was a way to save Eve on her home planet, Sophia. During the Perilous Journey, they visited many strange planets and met fellow pilots from Metal Attacker Battle Tanks. After tense encounters and ultimately working together, their bonds deepened. With help from the pilots, they defeated the Mutant Master of Dimensional Space, Drawl, Revo, and Eve's corruption was halted. At the end of the journey, they parted ways with the other pilots. And Jason built his damage tank into the new G-Sophia SV. Before long, they arrived at their final destination, Planet Sophia. However, a new crisis was already there, lying in wait for them. They were attacked by Sophia's army, with Sophia Force, and G-Sophia SV was rendered inoperable. Jason, Eve, Fred were captured and separated from each other. Why did they do this to us? Before Jason could find any answers, the base where he was held suddenly fell into chaos, allowing him to escape and recover G-Sophia SV. The fate of Jason and Eve and the fate of the planet Sophia all revolve around the threat of the Mutant Scourge. But now, an interdimensional reversal of fate is beginning. Let's go! Launch! Phew! I finally got out of there. This whole place is on high alert, and don't think it's because of me. There's no way I could have gotten G-Sophia and my stuff back without a big distraction like that. What in the world's going on here? The entire base is a complete disarray. No one has time to worry about an escapee in MA hangars. Evacuating the base needs to be top priority. Damn it! Eve! Fred. What in the world are you? Now, just in case you guys forgot, here are the controls! Speed jump, wide fire, R to aim, and angle. You can aim up, down, diagonally, and turn around. Pressing A, as we'll find out here. Mutants, what do they do here? Sophia, mutants are known as the Inven Dark Star Army. They've been driven away once before, never back on the move. Looks like most of G-Sophia's equipment is gone, figures. Fight with mutants like this. Earth MA-001-SV. Gaia Sophia SV. Interplanetary all-terrain battle tank builder. Most of the equipment was removed, so SV NSF could analyze it. President cannon crushes off. Sub-weapon, warhead missiles should still be operable. Space armor looks pretty fit, though. Crush shot alone won't do much. Some warhead missiles should pierce right through it, though. Using sub-weapons, some SP. SP reserves are crucial to reduce of G-Sophia's, SV's, and guys. This is first shocks and impacts to SP. That's right, that means it pop to lights to recover SP. When SP runs out, just be able to shut down and I'll be in trouble. On the other hand, I won't accomplish all that much of a prestige of SP. Let's go recover some SP every chance I get. And yep. However, there's two bars. So what does the other bar do? Well, the other bar, we'll see for later, is one of the things I like about this game. Talk about the bar later. And now we go. Come on, Sophia. We'll still need to leave you, Sophia, behind you over here. Still, it's crucial to the base comms. Civilians are inside here. Somewhere to press them. By time, the time to escape. The map is a rainbow. Walls and gate. Red lights. But ready? They say it's the only way. Let's go in. And we have to hold up to go in. Because of the changes. The means already made it as far from side base. And I got my pilot gear. When I escaped, I'm toast. Pilot gear includes a G rifle, full, and the back mounted Roddy Blaster rifle. The gun rifle has 5 weapon types that can handle a variety of enemies. Higher gun levels will increase the shot's firepower and rate of fire. Roddy Blaster Rifle finds powerful sub-weapons with special properties. My suit, weapons, and my broken helmet. He fixed it off of it for me. Now the only thing is keeping me safe from the mutants. Same Eve. And he's not joking! We get 5 different weapon types. Power, and we'll go over them a bit later. Pressing B allows us to dash. Bar is a dash map. And now wait to show off the blast counter. It's still the same as it was in 2, but it's honestly gotten better. Now let's get this upgrade. This game honestly feels so much better and faster than the previous Blaster Masters because of this dodge. Pressing A allows us to use some weapons. And then we've got our enemy rushes. Glass counters are going to be the one thing keeping us alive. Here's the map. This is our tutorial for dashing. Now, there's a big change from Jason. This is bad. We can fly! So, this water isn't really needed. Which also means, anytime we die, it should not be the game's fault. What in the world? It's like cracks. There's a crack in space itself. Which I'd attempt to check this out, but I'm gonna get back to G-Sphere. And this is our gimmick of summoning G-Sphere. We'll talk about what that single is. And oh boy, games of the enemies. Life Energy Guard Beta. Prevents enemy's life from dropping one time when taking damage. A swollen shield up to 60 can be held at once. This lifeguard and this light and shield guard even prevents the pilot's gun load from dropping. Just keep down for these. I'll need them when things get rough. I don't know why he says this one, because this one doesn't, I believe. Like again, like the previous game. Dash, jump. And here's Sphere Force tanks. With Puppet Light Sophia. Here's an optional thing. This is another SF facility. Mobile soldiers used by SF were great to battle with mutants. For as endless amount of them, they'll attack any outsiders. Going against them on first mistake one will soon forget. I missed that chance getting into them in gear like this. Straight off my escape route too. I don't have time for detours. I need to get out of here quick against that. Well, we're going in here anyway. Still can't do anything with that, but we'll soon. Oh, we're getting a good setup. Okay, let's dash. And SP up. That's one of our upgrades. Sub SP up and Life Energy Guard Alpha. This will be useful for us later. Now let's leave. Sometimes we can't go back, so be careful. And then again, there's rarely times you don't want to head forward. Nice! Go for this quite simply. Keeping me cover. But we're seeing some familiar things here in Sophia as a part of Sophia Force. Can't get that. So. Be able to get one down there though. Is there anything about that yet? Yeah. can. We need hover. Good news is, yeah, these are checkpoints. I'm not getting good luck with health, apparently. Literally just an anti-destroying thing. God. There we go. That's not what I wanted though. But checkpoint. So. There's one thing you'll notice a lot is that a lot more of these mutants are docile. Not harmless, but they aren't as aggressive as they once were in previous games. About a lot of enemies in this game. And that's because this game has probably the most annoying enemy types. But thankfully they're not egregiously bad. Just a bit annoying. I wish this game would do, would charge my stamina faster. Can't do much about that. But we get the lifeguard. Let's return. Getting as much as we can is a good thing. However, since we can't really do, we're not even done here, so we'll have to come back later. But I do have. Oh my god. Well, there's a good thing. Alright, we can't do this. All good. But I will say, Don't get used to thinking that you're done areas. This game has some mean things it does. Granted, it's rare that it does it, but it still does it. Now we'll try and do some different things. jumps. Health. And I know what you're thinking, right? You're thinking, oh, there's no life upgrades in this game except the armor ones. No, there is life upgrades, but it's weird. That's what you're doing. And that's why I hate these enemies. Also takes up energy, which is annoying. But hey, it's not bad, it's just... Especially since, like, with those enemies. I do like that they tried to make the energy guard not OP. Nice. And we've got... Well, that's a familiar stance. Is that Mutant Overlord? No, wait. Those are clones! Go is. It's the Archmute who led the Mutant army that attacks Sophia. Even as mere clones, they aren't to be underestimated. Blast Cannon, it's possible. I'll take them all at once. This is where we're going to talk about the Blast Cannon. Even though we really should know about this so much sooner. Go is R. Yeah, that boss is a joke. This is one thing you'll notice for a lot of the bosses. They're not that hard. Drop! Pressure shot, plus. Now that other bar, now has a use. It's our main cannon bar. And I like this! Because it makes the main cannon not be something to fear, and I can actually start firing both. If I go crazy with both, it's on me! Instead of being like, well, I even just have to just suck up. Can't get up there yet. Can eventually. That or... get further. We jump with this area temporarily before we emphasize. Is that ribbon? Fred, can't believe you made it this far. Hold on, buddy, coming for you. Now, fly down. Fred, are you okay? Fred is the support arm that acts as a probe for G-Sophia. Selecting Fred's eyes on the submarine will warp the pilot to G-Sophia. And we can bet. This will be helpful compared to the other games. And this is its fully powered on state, so we need to be careful. Oh no. Wait. Oh. That's M807. Garuda. No way. Leibniz! See if Leibniz has followed us. If you don't know who Leibniz is, you'll find out. This game does a lot of patching up. So, who's the first boss? On the other side of this bulkhead is the exterior planet Sophia, which means you're finally here. You got here faster than I expected. The voice. So you're the guy who's been guiding me this whole time. I've been watching you closely. See you? You're in your vehicle's power. That should be you in your vehicle's power. Well, you led me all the way here. What do you want with me? Isn't obvious? Listen. Escapee Jason Frednik. I am commander of this planet Sophia. It is my duty to neutralize all possible threats to this planet. Commander? Then why? And is that a metal attacker? Correct. This vehicle's name is Metal Attacker. Both G Sophia you have now, the Sophia the Third you once piloted, are part of the MA series, and this here is the original. Nice reference to Meta Hype. Are you serious? Then you must be pleased to finally meet you, though I wish it were under better circumstances. My name is Kane. Kane Gardner. Kane Gardner? You're... Planet Sophia scattered the MA series across space to battle mutants. This man is one of the engineers of the MA I found on Earth, Sophia the Third. When Eve was in danger, he even sent Sophia Zero to help us. In a way, even I owe him our lives, so why is he? Kane, please, tell me where she is. Why did you do this to us? Well now, that's enough chatter. I have a duty to fulfill. On guard, Jason Frednik. Sophia the Third, Nora MA1, Metal Attacker. In a fight. I can't get up here. Please, just let me through. I'm normally not one to turn down a fight, but I'm running out of time. Okay, I switched the channels. You should be listening in now. What? Alright, now listen. I came here to make sure you escape. What do you mean? You just beat up my tank! Our battle on the elite put some damage on my metal attacker. Now the records will show that you fought me and got away. Now, no one would be suspicious about an older old model losing to a new one. You must understand that I have my own standing to protect. I couldn't just let a prisoner take an MA and escape without a fight. But what is your reason for letting me go like this? That said, isn't it obvious? My goal is your goal. For the moment. Eve's held captive, and it's up to us to help her. Tell me where she is. Well, she's no longer being held. Things changed before your escape. After she was captured, alongside you, she disappeared. But, unlike you, there was no way she could have escaped. There's no way to describe it other than disappeared. At the same time, they and them, the mutants, appeared all over Sophia. So the mutants really are behind this. This is Sophia Force, suspect that Eve is connected to the mutant revival. You think she revived the mutants? There's no friggin' way. Eve is supported to recruit assistant MA, her MA in fighting the mutants. She would never help her enemies do something like this. It's impossible. As a support droid, Eve is not related to me by blood. But as a genetic model, I am like a father to her. We would never think Eve, our daughter, would do such a thing. But looking at the circumstances, we have to consider all possibilities. Furthermore, we've confirmed the presence of dimensional ruptures. Dimensional ruptures? I mean, that cracked space is horror. We're still investigating, but there's no doubt the mutants are involved. From me to experience, the mutants return, the dimensional ruptures. It's hard to think that all three phenomena are totally unrelated. Eve. Just so you know, your escape was related to the events of V2. I was able to come into contact with you, thanks to that, however. Your transmission did come through at very convenient times. Convenient, you say? Must be in your imagination. I believe you called. He picks up. Well, trouble. We've got trouble. It's taking too long. Now, reinforcements are on route. Sticks with you. You'll need it out there. Finally! Hover! Leave everything here to me. Just make sure you escape. Once you get outside, the base, the receiver should pick up a new signal. Got it. However, on the outside, you'll be identified by SF as an escapee. They'll treat you as a threat to planet Sovere. They'll likely register your name and attach with an official enemy code. That's the one that shows up before a battle, right? Nice gameplay and story integration. Do you know the enemy code my enemies AI created for you when we fought? How could I possibly know something like that? Well, if you ignore the fact it's an enemy code, it's quite fitting. Anyway, next time we meet, I won't be able to go easy on you. Do what you can to stay out of the SF sites. Just for you. She may even pick up the signal from you or G Sophia and contact you. Best of an eye, don't have that ability. Believe in bonds. Got it. I'll find her, no matter what. Okay. From now on, we're enemies. Now get going, Blaster Master! And we've escaped! We have a new code, and we know who is the Blaster Master. This must be the ruins of a safe, destroyed in the last mutant attack. Probably used safe where raw materials are rebuilding, so punch of this place is completely abandoned. But still, there are a lot of places to hide from SF around here. Did Keen have that in mind when he guided me and GSP out of the base? There's no way he planned all that, right? This is Eve's location there? I see two signals though. What's going on here? Both signals look like Eve's, but something's still slightly off. Eve! Eve, please respond! I'll have to do one location signal for now. I should probably check the signal's location on the map on screen too. And now, finally free. That is something that happens. Yeah, that comes from the globe. Oh, fine, we don't have any armor now. Eve? No, that's not Eve. That's a mutant clone of her. God, be kidding me. I thought I got a spot from Eve. No, it was this damn mutant. The lair of evil Eve. And they turned to fish. Well, that's what it looks like to me. I know it's not, it's probably meant to be like cells. That was a nice rushing attacker. Nice new blast counter. So didn't happen to come across anything useful. Someone did find us though. Jason Frontlick. Guess you didn't keep the bucket yet. What is that, Lena's? How did you get into G Sophia? Hang on. You're still alive! Were you hoping I wasn't? That'd be probably better for you. Still in peace, alright. Welcome to your MA, Garuda. SF got her hands on it and scrapped it as soon as I landed. Sophia totally swarmed me. Thankfully, I found a certain MA of yours and decided to hijack it. Okay, now how about it? Ready for a fight to death? Nope, I have no reason to fight you. I've heard that one before. You finna care about your reasons. I sure do. It's pretty obvious. Look, I know you called up our MA pilots for help to save Eve back then. Then you went to went so far to fight off the mutants attacking her. Oh, that. If I knew it would end up that way, I never would have gone. Heard the Earth was safe again now. But what really happened back there? No matter how things end up, I still have no reason to fight you, Venus. You're so lame. I'll just sit back and watch you suffer then. You've got loads of enemies already. The SF and the mutants after you. So I don't suppose you'll help me out in exchange for not fighting you. Not a chance. At the end of the day, I just want you dead, you know. Just be glad I'm not going to say something to blame like, I shall be the one to break you. I really could care less who breaks you. I just want to be there to see the spectacle when it goes down. Yep. Still the same old jerk he was before. This really is the perfect setup. I have a front row seat. There's even a radio back here, so if you get all lonely or whatever, feel free to call me from the subscreen. I'll make sure to regret your decision every time you call. I want out of here, but I can't just leave without my name. Yeah. Suit yourself. Oh, and by the way, I installed Guru's sub-weapon on your MA. Since I thought I could use it. Seriously? Homing laser! Lock-on laser with perfect accuracy? Hold the sub-weapon button briefly for a single lock-on. Hold on longer for multi-lock. If you can't hear me rub my hands together, this is my favorite sound weapon in the whole series. Funnily enough, it comes from Leibniz. Whoa, it's right here. Home laser. Forget all the Gap ahead won't open unless you hit all six switches at once. Hold the sub button to lock onto multiple targets. You did read the exclamation that popped up just now, right? Yeah, I got it. Should hit again on the sub menu info screen too. Don't come crying to me if you don't get it. Come on now, get on with it. Huh? A transmission. Jason, can you hear? Eve, you're okay. Where are you? Thank goodness. It's Jason. I had much time. Ock. The signal's weak. Something interfering with it. Listen fully. Son, use Elements Verve System I install. Helmet? The Verve System? Right, you repaired my helmet. It's danger, but it only what? Get past Dimensional what? I could hear. Ruptures. No. I'm out. Time. Eve! Oh, I lost communication. Oh man, I had a feeling something was missing. This should be going to be more entertaining than I expected. Entertaining, huh? Okay, I've traced the signal. Was that our signal after all? Yeah, let's try down the signal. He was there, I'm sure of it. You're sure of it? Huh? This is gonna be good. And yep! I believe this is here. I just want to clear things up. If you're expecting me to rush gallantly to your rescue when you're laying on the brink of death, or if you're imagining standing back to back fighting off mutants, you got another thing coming. As if I was wasting energy. Don't worry, I wasn't speaking to him, sort of thing. Oh hey! At the very least, I'll lift a single finger. Then use the point and laugh at you. We're seriously the worst. Yeah, leanness won't be helping us. Yeah, he won't tell us. But I will be talking to leanness compared to the other times of Eve. Because leanness actually does have some hilariously information. G. Sophia, SV, huh? What's the SV even stand for? Supreme Vehicle. Wow, big name for small change today. Oh, I found some audio data here. Yeah, and this is just teaching us. Jason does not like leanness. Sounds fun. I'll have a listen. I forgot he says that. Leanness will comment. Usually. Why drive a friggin' tank if you're not gonna maximize this potential? I love it. Oh yeah, I can't wait to watch you blast your enemies away, Mr. Big Spender. I love leanness. Homing laser is someone from my MA Garuda. So I guess you're gonna give me an explanation for this one? Seriously? I already told you how it works one time. How many times do you think I'm gonna explain the same thing to you? Sheesh. So I guess that's a no then. Yeah, leanness will explain homing laser more than once. So, yeah, don't expect any help. But, nope, let's press the wrong button. We can call. Alright, might as well just bring it up. Look at the top right. There's a ring. That will be important for later. Explaining that. to hear for Strikers. Mainly because of a reference. This is actually a used version of the old Striker weapon. Does it make you want to shout, Oversurge! Just like old times? No? Not really? If you say so. Nice Golden Bolt reference. Now, let's actually listen to this, because this one's actually interesting. Crosswave. Yeah, I know. This is what you've been waiting for. Yeah, nice reference to that everyone picks this one. But now you see why I love this. Energy Guard Bear. Just so good. It's no wonder. It's a wonder if this didn't actually hit us in his boss fight. And this is why, as a weapon, it's actually pretty good. Because it doesn't miss. And there's our app, hopefully. That's our ear look like. I think the only one I don't think gets some sort of look like weapon. Oh. SF machine is Kabiko. But we'll do this boss, and then end the episode off here. Cert Tube SP 1000. Usually I lose one life to this, so try not to map. Yeah, we can't get to that bottom one yet. A lot of things we can't do for a long while. This game expects you to backtrack a lot, but considering that to get the true ending, yeah, don't need to do much. Yeah, I'm not going to complain. But anyways, next time on Blastmaster 03, we will continue journeying with Leibniz, because really, what else are we going to do? This is Xena and Zuma, signing out.